Hello everyone, welcome to Beware Shoppy channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make a speed checker for micro RC car. If you don't want to bother building one yourself, you can buy Tamiya mini 4-wheel speed checker, which honestly, I should have bought one a long time ago, but I didn't, so now I'm gonna show you how to build one. Essentially what I do is use the Arduino to build a machine that counts the wheel rotation in 1 second and calculate the speed from it. What you need are first an Arduino. Obviously, I'm gonna use the Nano for this project. Next is a speed measuring sensor. I use the FCO3. Then a piece of plastic to make a wheel encoder. A rotary circle cutter to cut the plastic into a disc. And finally, a cutter knife. First, let's make the wheel encoder. You can make it by cutting the plastic into a disc. I made mine with 4 cm diameter. You can make it however you like, as long as it can go into the sensor. Then make a slot, so the sensor knows that it has completed one revolution. And then make a hole in the center to fit the wheel shaft. The hole that I make is for mini Z all-wheel drive. It is 3 mm long and 2 mm wide. The encoder works better if it has dark and non-reflective surface, so I'm gonna wrap it in black sticker. Once that's done, you can put it in place of a wheel like this. Since you have one wheel out, now is a good time to measure the diameter and take note, you'll need it later. Put the car on a stand when you run it, so the wheels won't touch the ground. Now move on to the Arduino and sensor. You only need to connect 3 wires, power, ground and a digital pin. Connect VCC to 5V. Ground to ground. And digital out to pin 2. Moving on to programming. I use the Tamiya library to make things easier. Link to download is in the description. The link for this sketch is also in the description. I'm going to explain the code, so you understand what's going on and where you might have to modify it. First, I'm defining the pin and some variables for rev counter, pi value, wheel rotation and speed. Next is the wheel diameter from the measurement I got earlier. If you use different wheels and tires, you'll have to change this. In the setup, begin serial, so it can print the result to serial monitor. Set timer 1 to initialize 1 million for 1 second. Then, attach interrupt to count the wheel rotation from encoder with count function. Next, attach interrupt for timer to call for printing the speed and reset count every second. Go up to see the count function. It'll count every time the sensor is tripped. Next is the getRPS function, or revolution per second function, which will run every second from timer. At the beginning, the timer is detached. Then it is attached back at the end of the function. In the middle, we are going to calculate the speed, which I'll talk about later, and also print the result and reset the counter. Now, let's check how many times the sensor read the encoder in one revolution. because this might be different from sensor to sensor, so it's better to check first. Right now, just print the count value every second is enough. Now, open the serial monitor and put the encoder on the car. Take note how many times it counts when the hole is passing through the sensor. My sensor reads 3 for each pass, so I can calculate the rotation by dividing the counter by 3. And after that, you can calculate the speed by multiplying it with the circumference of the wheel, which is the multiplication between pi and wheel diameter. At this point, the result is in millimeter per second. To convert it to kilometers an hour, multiply it by 0.0036. In summary, every second, it will print out the wheel rotation and convert it to speed in kilometer per hour. Here's how you set up the speed check. You prop the car up and let the wheel encoder go into the sensor. Open the serial monitor. Then run the car, and you'll see the speed printed out on the screen. Let's use it to check my latest setup of WLtoys with 10T pinion and 29T spur. You can adapt this to use with other cars by changing the encoder disk on the car and the wheel diameter in the program. And that's it for this video. I hope it is helpful. Please subscribe if you want to see more content like this and press the bell icon to get notification whenever I upload a new video. You can follow me on Facebook to see what I'm doing between videos along with some quick updates. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.